Welcome to Keybase by Metanic. This video is about the download, licensing, and configuration process of Keybase. At first, we need to go to metanic.com. Here, we go to Products. And besides other high-quality products of Metanic, we can find the free Keybase here. To get the free Keybase, we need to download first the setup, which is here, and afterwards the license, to which we come here. To download Keybase, we go to Download Free Trial, and it brings us directly to this download area. From here, we can choose between Windows or Mac. In my case, we click on Windows. Then we click on Save. Now the Keybase setup will be downloaded. After downloading the Keybase installer, it is recommended to save it in an individual folder. In this folder, the license will be installed too. So, in order to install the free license, we need to click on Order Now. Okay, we now can place our order by submitting our email. Our first name and our last name. We need to agree with the terms of service and privacy policy. And if you wish for, you can get updates about our products and offerings. After we have done the ordering, we can download the license now by clicking on Download Now. We now shall have both the setup and the license in one folder. In order to install Keybase, we now click on the setup, on next, we agree to the terms, and we check the license key box. Here you can choose your destination folder. We click on next. Again, the second destination folder for your VST plugin. Next. And the 64-bit VST2 plugin. Next. Okay, now we can go to the license key file. It's the file you already downloaded. And if you have it in the same folder, the setup can find it easily. If you don't have it in the same folder, you can go to Browse. And you can search for your license. Afterwards, we can go to Install, and the setup will install Keybase. All right, after downloading Keybase, we are now in Keybase, and I will show you how to set up and arrange the Keybase. We add an instrument, and by the instruments, we type in Keybase, and here it is. We go to Add Track, and here is our Keybase. If you don't find it in the Add Track menu, you can go to Studio and to Plugin Manager. Here at VST Instruments, you have an overview over every instrument you have currently running on Keybase. If you can't find Metanic Keybase in here, you can go to the settings wheel, go to the plus button, then you can choose the path where you installed your Keybase in. Well, then let's dive directly into the Keybase. Okay, so on the top we got the tone, the fuzz, the mode, and the key. And also we got to the left a bass booster, and if I want to play something, for example, something like this, and we want to adjust some tone and take the fuzz on and lower a bit the bass booster, and we hear now again. then we can hear an immediately difference. We also can turn off and on the whole plugin just with this knob, like a bypass. And we can easily assign those knobs to our MIDI controller by just clicking on this knob. And now we can see the color changed. If I now click, for example, to the tone and I want to adjust a knob or the wheel, the mod wheel, for example, I can just put it up. And now I have it assigned. Okay, let's take a look at the settings. We have the MIDI area. Here we can adjust the polo or monophonic. We can also turn down the tune two octaves here. We got an amp enveloper to set the attack and decay. Also, we got a retrigger button. And as well, we got a low pass filter, which we can turn on and off and adjust the cutoff. And for sure, we got a LFO mod, which we can turn to on or to envelope. And for sure, we can also assign all of those knobs to our MIDI controller. Keybase also works with the Cubase preset bar, so we can switch between presets really naturally. If we now want to set up an effect, for example an echo or reverb, we can click on the audio inserts and add a new effect. In this case, we add LEM Echo Music, another high quality echo plugin by Metallic. And first we will hear the sound without the plugin. And now I take off the standby. And like with the Keybase, we also have some presets, which we can choose here. Okay, we also have some settings which we can adjust, and this red little window will pop up. We can, for example, adjust the reverb amount and the master. We can adjust the pans on the stereo, so on the right and on the left. We can also adjust the volume. And we also can mix down it to mono or stereo.